In this video, we're just going to go over real quick how to read real data, or you know, floating type data, using the read var. In this case, it is in an M580 and control expert. You're probably, if you're watching this, you're probably already aware that the read var, no matter what data you're trying to read, it all comes back as an int, an integer value. And if you're trying to read reals, you know, it's not very useful data. So I've already got a read var set up here, reading from another controller. If you need help setting up the read var itself, there are other videos for that. But you can see here, I have this set up, and here's your reception array. Let's take a look at that. As I mentioned before, that reception is an array of int. There's no way around it. That's just the way that the read var works, and write var as well. But in this case, looking at the read var, trying to read real data. So I'm going to take this read var and we'll put it into an animation table. I'll show you here that you know, the exchange number is counting up, so we know that the read var is working. And the data coming back here. Now, all this data is, you know, floating points, real data from the other controller. Not very useful here, okay? So what we want to do is get that into useful data, into a real data type. There are several different ways that you could do this. I'm just going to show you a couple here. What I believe to be the easiest and quickest way to do this is to actually create a real array and actually locate it on the same register location as your reception array. There are, you know, other ways to do it, you know, through logic, which I'll show you something quick here. Again, many different ways you can do it. You can set up your own logic, however you want to do it. But again, these are just some quick, simple tips. So show you here. So the reception right now that I have is actually not located. You saw the data coming in, but what we're going to do is actually locate this now to a register. Okay. Now on top of that, we're going to create another array. But this is going to be an array of real. Now this is only a length of 5 because the a real is a 32-bit data type. So it's 2 ints to 1 real. Now we're going to locate this, as I mentioned before, to the same register as our reception. What is going to happen is when the read var grabs the data and it comes back into the reception array, now that data is also going to be put into %MW20. Now that we have this array, it is automatically going to be moved into this real array. Okay, so let's build this. And just to let you know, with the default project settings, you will get informative warnings letting you know that there is some data overlapping. And this is, you know, these are put in place to make sure that you are not overwriting data that you didn't intend to overwrite. In this case, we are intending to overwrite this, so this is acceptable. You can shut this warning off if you want to. You can go to Tools and Project Settings and change your build messages. And if we go over to Overlapping Addresses, right now it's set to generate a warning. You could make it an error, but then the project will not build in this case if you're going to use this method. Or you can shut that off and you won't get the messages at all. It's up to you, but this could be useful in other situations if you were not intending to overwrite data. In this case, we are. So we're just going to leave it for now. Table. There's our data. Now we're going to add in our new array. And there you have it. Now you have useful real data that you can use for you there. I believe, you know, in my opinion, that's probably the easiest and quickest way to do it. Show you one other quick one here. This is through logic. This is actually just a small DFB. Look at the logic inside that DFB here. So essentially what we're going to be doing is just taking two of the ints, a low and a high word, and outputting a real value. So we'll take that DFB. Than what you see on the left side of the block. Just to verify, we can look at that first reel here, and that matches up. So again, just a couple quick, easy ways to take this int data that's not useful and move it into a real data type that is useful for you. All right, thanks for watching.